Chernenko became the third Soviet leader to die in the last 3 years. Upon being informed in the middle of the night of his death, US President Ronald Reagan reportedly said, "How am I supposed to get any place with the Russians if they keep dying on me?" Chernenko was honored with a state funeral and was buried in the Kremlin Wall Necropolis. He is the last person to be interred there. From 1930 to 1933, he served in the Soviet military on the Soviet-Chinese border. After completing his service, he returned to Krasnoyarsk and worked as a propagandist. In 1933 he worked in the propaganda department of the Novoselovsky District Party Committee. And then a few years later he was promoted to head of the same department in Uyazkraikum. After the death of a Soviet leader, it was customary for his successors to open his safe. When Gorbachev opened Chernenko's safe, it contained a small folder of personal papers and several large bundles of money. Several more bundles were also found in his desk. It is not known where he had got the money or what he intended to use it for. During Brezhnev's final years, Chernenko became immersed in ideological party work. He led Soviet delegations abroad, accompanied Brezhnev to meetings and conferences, was a member of the commission that revised the Soviet constitution in 1977, and took part in the Vienna arms limitation talks in 1979. Chernenko started smoking at the age of 9, and he was a heavy smoker as an adult. Years before his election as general secretary, he had developed emphysema and right-sided heart failure. In 1983 he had been absent from his position for 3 months due to bronchitis, pleurisy and pneumonia. At Yuri Andropov's funeral, he could hardly read the eulogy. People struggled to catch what he was trying to say. He spoke rapidly, kept coughing and stopped repeatedly to wipe his forehead. He ascended Lenin's mausoleum by the newly installed escalator, and descended with the help of two bodyguards. During Brezhnev's time as Soviet leader, Chernenko's career continued successfully. He was nominated in 1965 as head of the General Department of the Central Committee, and given the power to set the Politburo agenda, and prepare drafts of Central Committee decrees and resolutions. Chernenko joined the Komsomol in 1929, and became a full member of the Communist Party in 1931.